Hello everyone, in this particular clip I'm going to explain something in astrology. So if you are a person who is not interested in this astrological topic, then you don't have to watch this clip anymore. In this particular clip I'm going to explain whether is this birth your last birth or not? What is the planet which governs this, and that planet where it should be, etc. There are 9 planets which we know that are more powerful on us. Because we are in the earth, the rays from these planets will create different sorts of vibrations. Sometimes it's a good vibration, sometimes it's a bad vibration. When that planet is very far from the earth, it has a different impact. When it is very close to the sun, it has a totally different impact at the time of your birth. Out of these 9 planets, 8 planets are the one which will work very powerful during your lifetime. One planet, actually its job starts only after we leave this body, and its job is to make sure where we have to go next. And that particular planet is Kedu. Kedu is called Jnanagaraga, a planet with wisdom. This Kedu, when he is placed in different positions, will always create very minimal impacts when compared to Rahu. Rahu and Kedu are actually shadow planets. They always will be in the 7th house from each other. Okay, when Rahu moves, Kedu will also move. And that's why the transits are called Rahu-Kedu transit, not just Rahu transit or not just Kedu transit. Whereas for Shani, it's only Saturn transit. For Guru, it is Jupiter transit. For Rahu and Kedu, it is always together. So Rahu has more powers during our lifetime, whereas Kedu has less power during our lifetime. So what is the job of Kedu? Kedu is going to take us to the next level based on the karma what we do. And Kedu do have some powers during our lifetime, only for those who are born with Kedu in the 12th house from the ascend. 12th house talks about life after death. 12th house also talks about expenses. 12th house also talks about foreign travel. 12th house also talks about mukti, moksha. And only if Kedu is there in the 12th house, that is when it's considered to be the last birth for you. If you look at your horoscope, just have a look whether Kedu is there in the 12th house. If Kedu is there in the 12th house, what he does during our lifetime? He has powers, I mentioned, no? He has powers only for those who have Kedu in the 12th house during the lifetime. What he does is, he will never allow you to get attached to anything. He will try to separate you from the life bondage. All sorts of attachments, you will completely stay away slowly. Initially, he will try to dump everything on you. All sorts of different relationship, all sorts of happiness, all sorts of comfort initially. Making sure that all your desires are coming to an end. Putting it to an end. Kedu will do that if he is in the 12th house. You will enjoy the life to the maximum. That's what I would say. Kedu in the 12th house also will make sure that whatever your desires are, you will get it during the lifetime. Because he has to take you to mukti, moksha, after this. So, when will a soul go to mukti? Moksha is only when all its desires are fulfilled. So, he will make sure that happens. And then what he does is, slowly, he will put you in trouble. Trouble in any sort. It could be family issues, or it could be conflicts with the wife, conflicts with kids, conflicts with parents, relatives. Making you to frustrate. And that frustration, what happens is, you will try to stay away from them. If you don't want to get into all these things, there is remedy, obviously. Okay, in Jyotish astrology, everything has a remedy. Don't worry about it. But I am not going to tell that remedy here. I am just explaining whether how to find out whether this is your last birth or not, and what will happen. So, it will create all sorts of troubles, making you to realize that we have come here for some time, and we have to go back. The true wisdom he will give. He will create a financial loss, frustration on money, frustration on opposite sex, frustration on family. Not much attached. Even if you are very close relative, if you hear a news that something bad happened to them, you will not cry. It's very hard to see tears in your eyes. Because he will make your mind in such a way that you will live in this world like a water drop on a lotus leaf. On the lotus leaf, if you see the water drops, it will not stick. So you will also not stick to this world. You will not stick to this life. This is called Sannyasi Yoga. Sannyasi Yoga people, mostly they won't get married. Mostly marriage is not there. Even if you get married, conflicts with wife and kids. Separation from wife, separation from family. You live in one place, family lives in another place. But Kedu in the 12th house will make you a philanthropist. You will be very generous. You will be very kind. You will donate a lot without others knowing it. You will do everything in secret, all the good things. Because only by doing service to the mankind, it is a service to God. Then only you are, that is how you are yearning punya to go to the next level. So, this video, I'm making it very clear. If Kedu is there in the 12th house, that is you, this is your last birth. No more birth at all. Okay? But, if you want to lead a peaceful life, if you want to still stick to worldly desires and you wanted to nullify this effect, there is a remedy. Okay? If you want to know what it is, you need to send me an email. My mail ID is murugabhaktan@gmail.com. murugabhaktan@gmail.com. Okay? That's all I wanted to say in this particular clip. Please do take care.